I just got home from spending a few hours with my mom. My allergies are so bad right now. Like, forgot to take an allergy pill before I went over to my mom's house, because regardless, I am allergic to pet dander, whether it's like cats or dogs, it really doesn't matter. Just allergic to it. So I was just like, my eyes were itchy, like my whole face was just itchy, like I kept sniffling, like I was just like, okay. And so I forgot to take it, but I just don't like usually taking it because it sometimes it tends to make me sleepy, especially like if I eat. And I took it like kicks it in more, so like I don't know, I end up kind of becoming drowsy. And so like, I mean, it's not as bad as Benadryl, but it's still not like something I really want to feel, so that's why I usually take it before bed. Like if I like go over to my mom's house and I spend the night, then I usually take it at night, like when I get there, because I'm gonna end up going to sleep anyway, so it doesn't matter. But I just didn't want to be even more tired than I already was when I was there, so I was like, whatever. But anyway, so I apologize if I'm still like kind of itching my face or like sniffling and stuff. I'm just still kind of like, it's still kind of in my system. So let me get on the video. I know my shirt, I'm like repping for another house, but let me just let you guys know, I love all the houses, honestly. I feel like I do feel like I'm a lot like Slytherin, but I also feel like there's parts of me that belong in other houses. Like I feel like if I was being sorted into a house, I feel like the sorting hat would honestly have like the hardest time with me, because I have so many strong qualities in other houses. Like, so honestly, I feel like I do relate with Slytherin a lot, but at the same time, like, I'm not against any of the houses. Like, honestly, I feel like I could fit in any house. Like, what I've always said was, I feel like, honestly, the reason I don't feel like I could honestly be in Gryffindor, like, 100%, is because I'm not the bravest person, honestly. Like, I mean, people say that I am, but when there's danger, I run. Like, I don't try to really find out what it is. Like, if, like, something's making a noise, like, I'm like, no, like, I'm not checking that. Like, I guess I have moments where I am brave, but I'm just not, like, yeah. I'm not as brave and as, like, whatever as, like, most Gryffindors are. Like, I literally just, I don't know. But when it comes to, like, kind of, like, the mischievous part of them and just, like, the part of, like, not kind of just following their own rules and, I don't know, just kind of being sporadic about things, like, I feel like I relate to that a lot. I mean, I feel like I'm courageous, I just don't feel like I'm brave. I know if that doesn't make any sense. Like, I'm courageous, but like, I don't know. It's hard to explain. Let me just say, I'm just scared of a lot of things, so yeah. And then obviously with Ravenclaw, like, that is my second house that I relate to the most, other than Slytherin. Like, I feel like those would probably be the two houses they would kind of wibble wobble with, because I feel like I'm a lot like a Ravenclaw. Like, I feel like literally there's probably only a 1% difference between like the Slytherin and Ravenclaw. Like, if I had, like I said, if I had to choose any other house to be in, like if I didn't have to be in Slytherin, or if I couldn't be in Slytherin, like I would choose Ravenclaw, like honestly. But I'm really into Ravenclaw, and like people, you know, I feel like, because Ravenclaws are smart, they're all about wit and intelligence, and that's like me. Like, I'm all about that. Like, I'm all about like wit and I don't know. Like, I'm just all about like about what Ravenclaws believe in. Like, honestly, like all of that. and I love to learn things, you know? And so, like, I feel like I'm, like, legitimately, like, 50-50, like, Ravenclaw and Slytherin. I always say I'm a Slytherclaw because, literally, like, I'm legitimately, like, mostly those two. And then Hufflepuff, of course. Like I said to you guys, I don't really feel like I relate to this house. I feel like this is the house that I relate to the least because, honestly, I don't feel like, and I know this might sound bad, like, and I'm not trying to make it sound bad, and I'll probably explain it better, but basically, like, they say that, like, Hufflepuffs are, like, 100% loyal, like, to everybody. And, like, the thing is like, I'm not like that. Like, I didn't want to be like, oh, I'm not a loyal person, because I am. I'm loyal when it comes to, like, relationships, for the most part. Like, I'm not, and, like, with friendships and stuff, but, like, for the most part, like, but what I guess differs me from the whole loyalty aspect with, like, me and, like, Hufflepuff is that, for the most part, Hufflepuffs are more, like, they're loyal to everybody. Like, everybody they come in contact with, like, they're just very, very loyal people. With me, I'm loyal, but only to, like, a select people. Like, only to, like, a select few people, because I feel like I'm loyal. Like, I'm not gonna sit up there and say that I'm your friend and then, like, I'm not. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna, like, go behind your back and do something when I said I was your friend. But at the same time, like, I'm not loyal to the point of if you do something really bad, like, if you, like, cheat on somebody or, like, you just do something that could really hurt somebody else, I'm not gonna be loyal to you. Like, I will tell the person. And I know that's bad, but, like, honestly, if my whole thing, especially with the whole cheating thing, like, I know I'm totally getting onto another subject here, but basically, I know that if I was being cheated on, I would want someone to tell me, and so, like, so that I don't have to waste any more time with that person. Like, honestly, like, I don't think anyone would like it if people know that this person is cheating on this person, and then no one has said anything. Like, I know people are like, oh, you're just snitch, like, I can't trust you. Well, you know what? What do you have to talk about trust? Like, you're freaking cheating on the person you're with, so whatever. You know what I mean? Like, so, like, you're the last person to talk about trust right now. So, like, I guess I'm not saying that, like, if someone, like, murdered someone, that a Hufflepuff's gonna be like, 100% gonna keep the secret, but I feel like they're a lot more loyal in that aspect than I am. Like, if you tell me you're cheating on somebody, like, I will tell that person. And I know that's kind of screwed up, but it's screwed up what you're doing. So I feel like if you're doing something pretty bad or, like, you're screwing me over, like, I'm not gonna be loyal to you. Like, that's just happens. But anyway, that's why I feel like I don't really, I don't know, like, that's why I feel like I'm not really, like, in it with the Hufflepuffs. Like, I'm not really fair. I mean, I am fair and I'm just, but, you know, I don't know. I just don't feel like I am very much like Hufflepuffs. I feel like I'm a little too crazy for them, honestly. And, like, Hufflepuffs, for me personally, are more, like, down to earth. They're very just, like, chill and, like, quiet, and I'm just not. That's just not me. I feel like, honestly, the only thing that I really, to be honest, take from Hufflepuff is the fact of how much they love animals, to be honest. Like, I feel like that's literally the only thing, is their love for animals and, like, magical creatures and, like, literally stuff like that. Like, I honestly, like, that, literally, like, the only thing that I take from that is, like, their obsession and love for, like, animals and taking care of animals and, like, living things, like, you know, like, not all living things, but you know what I mean. You know, so, like, honestly, that. So, like, my girlfriend, actually, which you guys know, she is, like, textbook Hufflepuff. Like, I don't feel, honestly, that she could really. I mean, I feel like she can have qualities of the other houses, but I don't feel like they're as strong as, like, her Hufflepuff. Like, honestly, like, I feel like she just textbook Hufflepuff. Like, I don't think that if she was sorted into a house, like, or if she was being sorted, I don't think she would have any problem. Like, I don't feel like the hat would have any problem. Like, literally, like, Like, it would be quick, like, literally the matter of 5 seconds, he would just be humble. Like, that would be it. Like, there would be no, like, hesitation, there would be no, none of him, like, thinking, like, literally would just say humble. Like, I feel like for me, I feel like he would kind of straddle the fence a lot. Mostly, I think, with Slytherin and Ravenclaw, to be honest. But yeah, so that's just kind of, I don't know what the whole point of this video was, honestly. I think I wanted to just talk about, like, what qualities I see in myself that are, I guess, in other houses, or, like, if I can relate. Because I've seen, Harry Potter channels. Like, I know I'm not fully a Harry Potter channel. Like, I know I do a lot of other videos. But I've seen, like, Harry Potter, channels, especially, like, the Bakey. I love her, dude. She's amazing. She's so funny. And, like, I don't know. Like, I just. Like, I've seen her do ones. I don't know if it was like this video specifically like this, or if it was just like part of the video, but I know that she did a video like on where she was talking about like if she like I think it was like a one about like Slytherins, because you know Slytherins do get a bad name and stuff like that, so I think it was something to do with that. But I think in the video she said like that she couldn't see herself in any other house. Like, she's 100% Slytherin pride. Like, there she just honestly, for her, like, she could not see herself in another house. Whereas for me, like, I could probably see myself in every house. Not so much Hufflepuff. Like, I honestly feel like that would be, like, the last house I would ever be in. Not because I hate Hufflepuffs or I think Hufflepuffs are stupid, like, some people do or whatever. I just think that I'm not as relatable when it comes to, like, the Hufflepuffs. Like, I feel like that would be, like, the last choice that I would be put in, honestly. But yeah, so I mean, I just want to kind of do a video on that because, you know, as you guys know, when I took my test on Pottermore, I did get a get Slytherin. So yeah, and then when I think when I took the test before, I got something else, but I honestly don't know, to be honest. But yeah, so I just kind of want to talk about that and everything. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this rant of my video and everything. If you liked it, just give me a thumbs up and subscribe, because I have a lot more content. I do stuff like this, and as of right now, starting in October, since like the beginning of August, me and Ashley have been doing like Halloween videos. So we've been doing Halloween videos lately. And then starting in October, we're going to be doing like 31 days of Halloween videos of some sort. We're going to be doing like DIYs. Like, we're going to be stepping it up. So check that out. I'm going to be trying to do. I don't haven't. I know I haven't really been doing videos about like serious stuff lately, or not serious stuff necessarily, but just stuff that like people don't really like to talk about because it's like controversial and crap. I might be coming out with some more of those. It's just, I just honestly haven't been wanting to do those for a while because they just take a lot of energy, and it's just, I don't like to really talk about that, like, negative kind of stuff a lot, like, for too much of a time. But I might be talking about some more stuff later. But yeah, but anyway, like I said, if you guys enjoyed, just hit the like button and subscribe, and I will catch you guys on the next one.